Hey there, best buddies, and what a pleasure it is to be with you today at the 2021 Best Buddies International Leadership Conference. I'm Nancy O'Dell, and I cannot wait to tell you all about this beautiful and wonderful young lady, Caley, right here. But first, I want to tell you a little bit about my involvement with Best Buddies. You may know me from hosting Entertainment Tonight for 9 years, and I'm currently with People Magazine's new TV show, but I am so very proud of my involvement with Best Buddies. I've been involved with Best Buddies since about 1994. And I say that it was God that sent me when I was a local reporter in Miami to cover something that Best Buddies was doing. And I met Anthony, who I know you all know there. And he told me all about Best Buddies. And I had an aunt with Down syndrome, my Aunt Ellen, who was my best buddy growing up. And I said, when I found out about Best Buddies, I said, my aunt would have loved this organization. It had not been formed when she was growing up, but she just always wanted to be included and involved, and that's what Best Buddies does so beautifully. So thank you for letting me be a part of this. Thank you for letting me be here with this wonderful lady today, and thank you all for being at the conference. And as Anthony mentioned, well, at the start of the event, there are over 3,000 people participating in the Virtual Leadership Conference this week. What an incredible event. Bringing together the best and the brightest leaders of the Best Buddies global movement. Give yourself a round of applause. Yes, we'll applaud them, Caley. And while I know that we all wish that we could be together this year in person at the conference, I am so extremely fortunate for the opportunity to be here with you today and to introduce you to an incredible friend, a leader, and an advocate of Best Buddies. Please help me welcome a fellow Californian, Miss Caley Versfelt. So good to have you here, Caley.
Thank you so much, Nancy.
Thanks for coming to my home.
Anytime, it's beautiful.
Oh, thank you very much. So how have you been doing? Because, you know, we've been in some strange times with a pandemic. What have you been up to and what's been going on in your life? And it's so nice to actually see you in person, both vaccinated.
Well, it is for that one.
Yes, what have you been up to?
So before getting vaccinated, obviously, I was scared to leave the house. So I took some classes and
some online classes?
Online, uh-huh. Yeah. Like production, acting, writing mostly a lot. I do a lot.
And she does it all, basically. Everything. Just wait till you hear it all.
And I've been helping my mom out a lot as well.
I bet she appreciates that.
She really does, actually. Because all of the kids love my mom so much, honestly. And I learned how to ride my bike during COVID.
It's a good thing to do.
So it was really nice to do things that is new for me during COVID. So it's amazing for that. I've been doing a lot of auditions too.
You have. She's an incredible actress. So I want to talk a little bit about that because you have some new roles. Tell us about your new roles.
So I was in Canada, obviously, and I loved it up there. It was like on my bucket list. So I was on the role on The Good Doctor.
The Good Doctor?
Yes.
That's a great show.
It is. It's fabulous. What? Everybody is so welcoming.
They are.
And so kind.
What part did you play?
So I did a part that his name is Jamie Clavner that did a liver transplant.
She had a liver transplant?
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
And it was really amazing work, I had to say, because the director, Friday Heimel, directed me so well. He complimented me and my professionalism and having fun with them. So it was fantastic, which I call fun-tastic.
Oh, that's a good word, fun-tastic. I think that's what everybody's doing right now at this conference, fun-tastic. And you are fantastic because you do everything. In fact, you also interview celebrities, just like I do. Yes. You don't take my job.
No.
We can do a talk show together. How about that?
I would love that.
Okay, that would be great. But you have. You've been interviewing celebrities. You've been doing it for the Media Access Awards, correct?
Yes.
What else have you done?
Well, I also interviewed this person in Pixel World Games with Hunter Hayes.
You like country music, don't you?
Big fan of country music.
Me too. Hunter Hayes, he's one of my favorites.
Yeah.
I loved hearing that. I was like, no wonder we get along so well, Caley, because we both love country music. And in California, not everybody loves country music.
Yeah.
I know.
Like some people like different kind of genres in music, but with me, I'm a hardcore country woman.
No, I love her. I love her.
Well, here's a funny part when I interviewed Hunter Hayes. Yeah. So, of course, it was It was a fabulous time, obviously. But when he asked me, who's your favorite country singer? I said, Keith Urban.
Oh, no. What did Hunter say?
He did. And now he's tied up with number one, of course.
Keith Urban is a good one to like, too. Yes. Yes. He's very cute. Yeah. Yeah. So is Hunter, though. So, well, I think that you do everything. You're such an impressive lady. I can't even tell you. So I want to know, what would you say to everybody out there and other people who have dreams that they want to fulfill? Because it just seems like you have gone for everything and you have really succeeded in it and a beautiful person at the same time.
So I would say, just go for it. Just be yourself like you've always been. Don't be shy or be the person that you are. Like, don't be ashamed of what you are and all like that. Like with me, I have some people who feel as bad about their disability. But I don't see that. This my disability, actually, because I do have Down syndrome, but I don't put limits on it. Because if somebody puts you on limits, you're actually challenging yourself.
Yeah.
So in a way, you're the person who inspired everyone to impact them to the world.
I think you need to have a talk show.
I do. That's my
You're so good at this. Yes, I think you should. I think that I'm going to get on the phone and call Oprah after we finish this interview and say, Oprah, I found somebody. I think I found somebody who needs to be your protege. What do you think about that?
I would love that. You hey, would. Oprah, I'm right here.
Yeah, that's right. I think you would be a great one. You have been the Best Buddies Global Ambassador, right? You've been involved with Best Buddies for 5 years. As the Global Ambassador, what is it that you enjoy the most? And what message would you have for everybody that you haven't already given us? Because you've given us so many great messages.
Well, being a global ambassador is life-changing. It helped me a lot being professional. And that makes me really special because I get to meet interesting people with great hearts and attitudes. Because we are all spreading kindness together. And I just love meeting new people and getting to know them. And telling my experience in Best Buddies. So I love it. Like, I love to talk. I'm in time box.
You're a good talker. And so, like I said, very infectious personality. So,
like, Best Buddies is like a big family. Yeah. And I love them as they are. And I love them.
And I know they love you. You have also been involved with the Best Buddies Jobs Program.
Yes.
What did you do with the jobs program?
So I'm the Entertainment Industry Foundation, and I work through the front of the office as the receptionist, as they call it, front desk administrator. Uh-huh. And I do a lot with them, like saying I do some conferences, I schedule appointments, entering cards, emails, maybe some packages or stocking, a lot.
Oh my goodness, yeah. You're very busy. How do you find time with your acting, too, to do it all?
I actually don't know.
You're like, it just works out.
Yes, we need a flex day, so I work Mondays to Thursdays and keep my Fridays open. Mm-hmm. But I feel like if I was substituting a day, I would get up on Fridays for work. But I keep Fridays open for my acting gigs, like auditions or something. I'm also a model, too.
Oh, my goodness. You do it all.
Yes. I describe myself as a journalist.
I hear you. You have a few personal accomplishments that you want to make as well, like you want to live independently.
Yes.
Why is that important to you?
So when I was in college, I learned a lot to be independent. I'm still learning, obviously. I bet everybody's learning that. But when I was in college, I've always dreamt to be like 30 years old and move out at that age. And now I am 20 years old, thank goodness. But I'm still learning. But I've always wanted to do a lot of things through that. And I really want to move out.
I have a feeling that you will accomplish anything that you put your mind to, Caley. I think that that's going to happen soon for you, Chris. You are amazing, as I said at the very beginning of this interview. And you also, I mean, she's done so many things. You also have a website called The Tides of Kindness.
Yes, I do. And my motto for that one is, kindness is contagious.
Yes, it is. I 100% believe in that. Yes. What is your website about? Is it to spread kindness? I know that you have some products on there, some t-shirts on there.
I do have some products, obviously, so please go on that too. Yes. With Touch of Kindness.
Some kindness t-shirts.
It describes being acceptance, spreading kindness as well, being included, and it's kind of like with my professional and my personal related too, with my COVID that I'm trying to go for, like you just said, with my toxo kind of thing. I do like a lot of great accomplishments. So it kind of describes with my piece of business as well with it.
Yeah, well, that's great. I can't wait to go and explore it a little bit further.
And everybody should be kind to each other.
No doubt about that, right? Wouldn't the world be a better place if everybody were just kind to each other?
Yes.
Yeah. And as global ambassador, I'm sure you're going to get that message out even more.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, you are 100% amazing. And I just cannot thank you for all the work that you do with Best Buddies. You're spreading kindness everywhere. You're teaching people about inclusion. You're teaching people about abilities. Mm-hmm. And I want to say thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for all the time. And you just let your star shine everywhere, because I have a feeling that you're going to be interviewing all kinds of celebrities everywhere if that's what you want to do.
It's my life dream. Entertainment is my dream.
Can I be the first guest on your show?
Yes, you may.
Promise?
Pinky promise.
Oh, pinky promise. Okay, that's it. You heard it right here. Love you, Caley. Thank you for your work with Best Buddies. So good to have you here. And bye to all of you. Have a wonderful conference. It's good to see you. Love Best Buddies. Go Best Buddies.
So I was just thinking, Caley and Nancy, like before we actually, you know, sit down and eat, I mean, when I come over here, I just had a couple announcements I wanted to make to you guys. If that works, maybe get a couple pictures. Come over. Right here? Okay.
Perfect timing. That's my
hair. Just look right here.
So Caley, this wasn't just about the interview today. I have something that I want to give you. We love you so much and you're so amazing. My daughter, come on, be a part of this, Ashby. She formed Best Buddies at her school, so she knows all about inclusion and how much the buddies are such a special part of all of our lives. So that's something I want to present to you today. You are being awarded the Spirit of Courage Award by Best Buddies for all that you do and the difference you make in so many lives. And we're so proud of you and so happy to have you as a global ambassador. And congratulations!
Woo!
Yay! We can all cheer really loud!
Caley, how do you feel to be with this award? I mean, you know how much it means and so many great people have received this award in the past. How do you feel about being our 2021 Spirit of Courage recipient?
I'm speechless. I'm here a moment and I'm like opening eyes right now. I love it. Thank you so much. I'm making tears right now.
Well, you have done so much for this organization and we are so proud of you, Caley. So thank you.
Thank you.
I think she's happy.
I think so. I think we did.
I'm born happy. I'm born excitement.
I know.
Oh my gosh. I'm so in tears.
You're very deserving. And this is David with Best Buddies. I don't know if you've already been introduced at the conference or not.
They all know me. But,
okay, good.
But I just want to thank you, Nancy, too, for being able to host us and Ashby and be able to present this at the house. I know with Leadership Conference, we would all love to be together. But we wanted to make this award as super special as possible, even with the pandemic, and wanted to deliver this award to you in person.
Well, I'm literally in
I think you're excited.
Well, yes, excitement feels.
Well, you're so deserving.
Thank you. Just
wonderful, absolutely wonderful.
I'm gonna make my mom so proud today.
No, oh, I bet your mom is proud of you every day, but yes, particularly proud today, right?
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. This means so much to me and my accomplishments. And that Best Buddies has always been there for me. And you're like a biggest family of all, so I want to love you guys, so thank you so very much. I'm like a little in tears, like I'm breaking in pieces right now. Thank you so much.
Okay. Woo! Now let's have some lunch!
Yeah, let's eat! Let's have some lunch!
Let's eat and celebrate!
once you see the people that you spend time with, you will know. That's the reason why you should donate to Best Buddies. Because if you get to know the person, you will know. It's kind of like how you feel like she's the one or he's the one. It's a bond, it's the one. That's what it counts to me. That's why you should fundraise to Best Buddies, because if you see us growing, wait until you see the fun out of it.
Awesome. We good there? Yeah. Okay. So, all right, we'll stop here. We're gonna go back into the conference room. No.
Oh,
what do we want to do?
We can just bring her out.
Okay.
Do you wanna?
Isn't there a staff member here?
One of our staff members here wants to like take a video or take a photo with you. So.
Yeah. So we're gonna have her stay here.
Yeah.
Okay. So just stay right there.
I don't mind. I love the camera. Really, I'm not shy anymore.
All right. So we have a surprise for you, Caley. Are you ready? I know you've had lots of surprises.
I love surprises.
Here we go.
I'm a surprise lady.
Guess who's here? Surprise! Congratulations! I heard all your nice words you were saying about me.
Anytime!
This is for you.
Thank you.
And this is for you.
Thank you.
I'm so proud of you and your award.
And that's it. And yeah, I was thinking to say that.
I heard her. I'm like, she said I'm going to be proud.
And my hard work through Best Buddies as well, and helping my community.
Of course.
And letting them know all about Best Buddies means to me. Mm-hmm. And I was like, I love my thing. I love being who I am, you know? Mm-hmm. It's like I
you
feel.
You should be. I'm very proud of you.
Yes. And so that's why I love. I didn't even expect to get it. I love surprises, but I was in tears. Mm-hmm. I was working like how we were all going together in tears. Aww. So it was like the moment I've always wanted to have. And it was something that I've been talking about myself that I don't want to get my hopes on it. Mm-hmm. So that gave my hopes really big, like you saw me last time.
Big dreams, yes.
And so I always tell myself that I doubt it, but I know I can.
Of course.
And that's what it means to me.
Yeah. Recently during COVID, I joined Best Buddies California and got to meet my beautiful friend Caley. Caley is incredible. She just won the Spirit of Courage Award and very deserving of it. And you've achieved so much, so I'm very proud of you and you deserve this so much.
I'm making it. I need you.
Go Best Buddies!
Yay! I love you, Best Buddies.
Thank you.
I need you too.